Did Zeelan shave off part of his eyebrow?
You be the judge. The setting said it was fine. I'm just packing some serious eyebrow punch, apparently. I'm suing the razor company. It's... Don't... Shut up. Okay? Hey, what's up? Welcome to a video that I'm sure is going to be mildly controversial, but that's actually not what I'm here for. I'm here to just give you the facts, and this is some facts, and they're there to support an opinion this time. And that's that there is a problem with the features in Football Manager 21. Obviously, the game is still in beta. If you don't know what that means, the full game has not technically been released yet. The beta is a 2-week period before the game is released on what is going to be November 24th that allows for final troubleshooting. But I'm talking about a larger conceptual problem that I think needs to be addressed going into future games. So, Zeeland, what is that large conceptual problem? Well, if you want to ask me important questions like that immediately, and you don't have to wait for me to make a video about it, I talk about this sort of stuff on my Twitch stream all the time. I'm usually playing Football Manager. Even if you don't normally go on Twitch or know what that is, I promise it's a good time. It's just like hours of me. And that class is narcissism. Back to your regularly scheduled programming. So the issue with Football Manager and the argument that I'm going to attempt to defend is that the features in FM21 do not fundamentally change the way that you play the game from FM20. Or in my opinion, really FM19 either. But the argument here is FM20 to FM21. And even though obviously this game was created during a global pandemic, at least in large part during a global pandemic, we are still taking it as a full new installation of the game. And thus I lay out this argument. In sections, I will present to you the major feature changes outside of the match engine, which I think has been wonderfully retouched in much more dramatic way than previous editions, which means I still believe at this point, and I'm holding on to making this video until later, I still believe at this point the game is worth buying because of the incredible match engine overhauls. But outside of that, the game really doesn't offer a whole lot in terms of a different feel to play. Here's what I mean. The first major new feature is something called a recruitment meeting. Now, this is designed to provide extra immersion. I love that. But there are a lot of people that play Football Manager that couldn't care less about the immersion that something like a recruitment meeting offers. And that's essentially who I'm making this video for, because I know that is a large contingent of the people that play Football Manager. They play it for the strategy, while I play it for the immersion, well, and the strategy, but for the immersion as well. In a recruitment meeting, you will interact with various members of your high-level staff. They will make recommendations about who to sign. And then you go through a couple of different players that are recommended at those positions. Then you will have the opportunity to set up a scouting requirement. And when you go into your scouting assignments, they'll be right there. You can assign your scouts to take on those particular scouting assignments. But of course, despite the immersion and this being a major feature introduction into Football Manager 21, this doesn't really change the way you play the game. In Football Manager 20, you would have your scouting person, whoever you've chosen in your staff responsibilities, to collect the scouting reports and present them to you. Then present all of those scouting reports, which included staff recommendations. Now, these staff recommendations weren't as zeroed in as the ones that you get with as much reasoning as you get in the recruitment meeting, but you get staff recommendations through the scouting center, and you're able to set up all of your own assignments that way. You might have had to go out on your own just a little bit more to do it, but this is kind of like the development center, which was introduced in Football Manager 20, that didn't actually change the way you played the game at all. It didn't introduce a new facet. And what I'm thinking about when I'm talking about introducing new facets is not this recruitment meeting that is just presenting the information in a fun new way, but something like dynamics, where you really change the way that you had to play the game. You introduce dynamics over here on the left, and all of a sudden you had, look at that atmosphere I have at Aberdeen, by the way. We are killing it in the beta save. Change the way you played the game. You had hierarchies, you had your leadership structures, you had the social circles, all of which you had to deal with and interact with and really bank off of before you made decisions. Well, the recruitment meeting goes in what I'll call the development center stash, where it's presenting new information in a fun and creative way, but it's not changing the way that you play the game for the better. What else from Football Manager 21 could go into this bin? Gestures, I was very excited about and I still like. I think that they are an improvement. Same way I think the recruiting meeting is an improvement, but I know a lot of people, they're not going to feel an increased version of strategy once they figure out how this works, because gestures, when you hover over them, are essentially the tone of voice that we've been using in Football Manager for years. So these team talks before and after matches, I have already reached a point in Football Manager 21 where I just basically know exactly what I'm clicking on, because when you hover over it, it'll say like, you're doing this assertively, you're doing this aggressively, which if you played Football Manager 20 or before that, sounds exactly like the tones. It's the exact same thing. Now, it's got a cool new background. It's definitely more immersive, and I like it. But does it change the way strategically that you have to play the game? No. Now, there are a few little things that Football Manager 21 has introduced that do strategically change the way you have to play the game. One, being able to contact agents strategically changes the way you have to play the game. You can get in touch with them. And if you didn't know this, by the way, you use Scouting Center, you get agent availability in the bottom right corner. Basically, you phone up the agent and say, hey, would he want to come here? How much would he want? What type of playing time would he want? What other things might he want in order to come to the club? That changes the game strategically in a fundamental way. You've not been able to do that before. Also, in your quick informal chats, these gestures are different. They're not associated with the tone, and so that makes it a little more intuitive, and you have to figure out kind of exactly how you want to approach the situation in a way that's not already automatic in your brain. There's small changes to the actual strategy of the game, and I think that if you are going to find that outside of the match engine, if Football Manager 21 feels maybe very familiar, it's been reskinned. I think this is a good game. I definitely think this is a good game, especially with the match engine improvements. But if you do feel like it's almost too familiar, this is why. I spent a lot of time thinking about it and trying to figure out why the game did feel so familiar. It's the development center approach all over again with a couple of the major features, which is the revamped interaction, the recruitment meetings. And then there's the side note that one of the major changes the Football Manager wanted to make is that in the revamping of interactions, they've got this whole new setup for press conferences. You can be sitting next to players in press conferences, dealing with that sort of interacting with them while you're talking about them, and you can see all of the different journalists and how they're interacting. Look, the answers are still largely the same. It's still not a particularly intuitive system. You still get questions that just feel like they don't make a lot of sense. It's better. I'm doing the press conferences now. I wouldn't be surprised if I turn them off at some point in the future, because I play the game for freaking 3,000 hours every year. And I look forward to the day that a press conference is so immersive and diverse that I won't even consider that, because I just automatically know the answers to every question. And the last small feature that does change the strategy of the game is that when you have meetings with players, the agent is also there. So the involvement of the agent in these proceedings, I haven't really seen that affect things too much. You just kind of see the agent being moody off to the side. But I suppose in certain negotiations, you could see the agent being mad and the player being happy and maybe use that to sow division or something. That is a change to the strategy of the game. But I think Football Manager, and really this is a video that hopefully illuminates the great things and the problems that Football Manager 21 has in terms of pushing forward. There's never been a perfect game ever made. I think when you make as many changes as they have during the COVID pandemic, that's more than enough. And we still have a good game on our hands. But it's an effort to point out that adding things like the dynamic section, adding things that make it worth buying the game every year, that change fundamentally the strategy that goes into the game, not the tiny stuff, but one or two large things that aren't the match engine, that change the way that you have to think about and play the game. Football Manager is never going to be 100% realistic. You're never going to get provided the exact same experience of managing an actual team. You keep up this level of match engine improvement every year. I've befriended Nick, the guy that makes it. He's more than keen to keep on that, and I think that's awesome. You make one or two other changes when you're not in a pandemic shortened year in order to change the strategy of the game instead of just the immersion. Hold on, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna create categories. Football Manager, we have strategy, we have immersion, we have optics, which is the visuals, and we have the match engine. Those are the four sections. I think three one of which, the match engine, which I think was this finger, is very important, that have really been taken care of in this edition of the game. But I think one that perhaps is the most important is the strategy of the game. That going forward, I think Football Manager needs to avoid making large features just aesthetic re-representations of information. I like the game and I look forward to playing the full edition of the game, but of course the beta is basically a polished version already with just a few glitches in it, but playing the full version of the game for a little while and then giving you guys my opinion about whether it's worth it. But I've talked about it on stream before. I used to only buy Football Manager every 3 years before I started making content about it. And I think the key to making it a necessary buy every year is being able to at least change a piece of the strategy in the game, a significant piece of the strategy in the game, in a positive way every year. Is it easy? No, but that's the problem with the features outside of the match engine in FM21. All right, I'll see you on stream, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok.